This video will go through the setup and configuration of IO-Link communication with a G6, an IO-Link master from Turck, and a C6 Smart PLC. To start, we will go through the setup that we have here. First is the G6 drive, which is a 230 volt single phase drive connected to an induction motor. The IO-Link interface is the X4B port, which is connected to the Turck IO-Link master. We have three connections. One of them is the power supply. The second is the IO-Link interface. We have four different ports for IO-Link. However, we are only using channel zero. And lastly, we have the EtherCAT interface, which is connected directly to the Smart. And this is the C6 Smart PLC, which we will be using to connect to the IO-Link master. We have two connections to the PLC. The LAN X6 port is for programming, and the bus X5 port is the EtherCAT master, which is connected to the Turck IO-Link block. And lastly, we're going to be using Combivis Studio 6, which is the IDE for developing PLC projects and configuring the drives. So let's get started. Starting out, I have a shell project that I already created. We're going to go through a few steps just to get the communication set up. Starting with the drive, the drive in the device tree is the node 1 G6LG device. To open that, I'm just going to double click here in the navigator tree. The first step is going to be to configure the process data. We can use a startup wizard to do that. If you double click on it, you can see that we have 4 bytes of data in and out that we'd like to use. To set up the process data, we can select the G6 parameters, and we want to set up the slots for the commands that we're going to be sending down to the drive. So we have the control word and the set speed value. To drag them in, you just select it, drag it over to the startup wizard again, right into the PDO slots that we have available. I'll do that for SY52. And lastly, what we want to send from the drive to the PLC will be the status word and the actual speed value. Now that the process data slots are set up, we can select download, and that will write the parameters down to the drive. The next step is to configure the IO-Link master inside of Combivis. I've already imported the device description in the Combivis. However, if you don't have that, you can find it on Turck's website. To set up the process data slots for EtherCAT, you can just double click on the device, and here we have the EtherCAT IO mapping. This is where you would map the variables from your logic into the EtherCAT channels. As you can see here, we already have variables defined for the control word, the target velocity, the status word, and the actual velocity. Lastly, we have a few startup parameters that are required. So here in the startup parameters, we need to define the functionality for each of the 4 channels. As I mentioned earlier, we have 4 IO-Link channels. However, we are only using channel 0. So we can enable that channel by just setting up the amount of data that we want to send and receive, which we have done. You have 4 bytes in and 4 bytes out. And then channels 1, 2, and 3 can be deactivated by setting them as a digital input channel. Now that that's complete, we can log into the C6 Smart PLC. After logging in, the process data between the C6 Smart and the IO-Link master will be set up. we created a visualization so that we can easily control the commands that are getting sent down to the drive. So here I've got the control word and the status word mapped, as well as the target velocity and the actual velocity. To run the motor, I can just select drive enable, run stop, and give it a command speed. And now we can see that the drive is spinning the motor and process data is transferring successfully. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us at KEB America.